Hi, welcome to videos on plotting the Bode plots. So this is the second part of these videos. So let us consider the transfer function, which is 200 divided by 1 plus 0.2s and 1 plus 0.01s and 1 plus 0.04s. We know that in the previous video, we obtained the value of omega pc and omega gc happens to be 55.9 radian per second, and omega gc is 124 radian per second, the corresponding the phase at which we have this phase at omega gc happens to be minus 217, and the phase margin happens to be minus 37.4 degrees, and the gain margin happens to be, so which is minus of the magnitude at omega is equal to omega pc. So omega pc happens to be 55.9 radian per second. So corresponding that omega pc, we have a magnitude of 16.05 dBs. So gain margin happens to be negative of that, that is minus 16.05. So we have seen in the Bode plot, so we know that this is 46 dB, which is at frequency 0.1. The first pole is existing at 1 over 0.2, which happens to be 5 radian per second. As you can see, this is 5 radian per second. So till 5 radian per second, the slope is 0 dB per decade. After 5, till this is actually 50 here. So sorry, this is 1 over 0.04 happens to be 25. From 5 to 25, the slope is minus 20. Now we can see, in order to draw this line of minus 20 dB per decade, so from this 5 radian per second, we came down by 20 dB. We went one decade here. Now this corresponds to 50. Now joining this point and this point will give a slope of minus 20 dB per decade. But we are stopping at 25, because at 25 there is a change in slope. So at 25 radian per second, the slope changes from minus 20 to minus 40. So now you can see we are coming down by 40 dB down, and one decade here. This corresponds to, this is actually 25. So this is now 250 radian per second. Now the slope is now 40 dB per decade. Now this line, sorry, this point and this point, we won't have a slope of minus 40 dB per decade. We'll not be joining this line in total up to 250, because we have one more cutoff frequency at 100 radian per second. So at 100 it stops. From 100, so we are coming down by 60 dB, and one decade here, this is 1K. So this point and this point, we're going to give a slope of 60 dB per decade. And we are joining this point and this point, and it is being extended till this point. We found that omega gc happens to be 130 radian per second on the graph, but theoretically it was found out to be 124. So this is upon equating the magnitude equation to 0 dB, we had it as 124, but graphically it is 130 radian per second, which is fairly okay. So corresponding to this frequency, we have a phase shift of minus 219, which corresponds to a phase margin of minus 39 degrees, and omega pc at the magnitude of omega is equal to omega pc happens to be 18 degrees. That's what we have here. So this is omega pc, which is 55.9. so from this 0 dB line, this is the magnitude at this point, which is actually this, which is AF omega PC happens to be 18 dB. So the gain margin happens to be negative of that, which is minus 18 dB. So since both AM and PM both are, sorry, GM, gain margin and phase margin are negative, the system is unstable. So now we are looking at, okay, how does this slope changes from 0 to minus 20, minus 20 to minus 40, minus 40 to minus 60, and how do we write this equivalent magnitude. So let us understand the plotting of the resultant Bode plot much more comfortably in the coming example. So let us assume that in this transfer function where we have two poles. One is at 0.1 time constant, other is a 0.01 is a time constant, and we have a gain of 100. Now we can see we have a term 100. So now we have there are three terms. All the three terms will going to contribute to the magnitude plot. See here, the term 100 contributes to the magnitude plot for all frequencies, whereas the term which is 1 over 1 plus 0.1s contribution is 0 dB till 100 reading per second. It will tell 10 radian per second. After 10 radian per second, the slope is minus 20 dB per decade. Similarly, for 1 over 0.01 into s, the contribution is 0 dB till 100 radian per second. After 100 radian per second, the slope is minus 20 dB per decade. So at 0.1 radian per second, only the term 100 will be contributing to the magnitude, so that the contribution of these two terms, that is 1 over 1 plus 0.1s and 1 over 1 plus 0.01s, the contribution is zero. So that's why at the magnet, at the center, the magnitude is due to only the constant value, which is 20 log of 100, which is 40 dB. Let us try to plot the resultant plot for this transfer function. MAO stands for magnitude at the origin with a value of omega equal to 0.1 radian per second. And you can see now we have written the terms, all the three terms. So this 100 doesn't have a cutoff frequency. So we have four columns. This is the term. The term should be always arranged in the form of increasing order of the cutoff frequency. This is, cutoff frequency is always 1 over the time constant. Since it is 1 plus time constant into s, so this is like time constant tau. The frequency happens to be 1 over tau. In this case, tau is 0.1, 1 over 0.1 is 10 radian per second. And in the second term, we have 1 over 1 plus 0.01s, where the cutoff frequency happens to be 1 over 0.01, which is 100 radian per second. We'll see what is the slope of each and individual term and the resultant slope. See, the first term is 100, it is not contributing any slope, the resultant slope is 0. The second term, which is 1 over 1 plus 0.1s, will have a cutoff frequency 10, meaning till 10 radian per second, its contribution is 0. After that, it has got a slope of minus 20 dB per decade. The resultant slope is the previous slope plus the new slope is the resultant slope, that is 0 plus of minus 20 is equal to minus 20 dB per decade. And the third term will going to have its contribution starting from 100 radian per second. And its individual slope is minus 20. So the overall slope, the resultant slope happens to be the previous slope plus the new slope, and the overall slope is minus 40 dB per decade. So let us see the plot now. As it was said, the term is 100, which is corresponding to a magnitude of 40 dB. Now we can see we have a plot of 40 dB till what point? Till next cutoff frequency. Next cutoff frequency is at 10. So this actually corresponds to 10 here. So this is actually, since this is 100, so this has to be 10. So at 10, the slope is 20 dB per decade. You can see at 10 radian per second, from this 40, I'm coming down by 20 dB and 1 decade. So this point and this point corresponds to 20 dB per decade line. So this will be extended till the next cutoff frequency. Next cutoff frequency is at 100. So it will be extended till this point. At 100, the resultant slope is minus 40, meaning at 100, I'll come down by 40 dB, go 1 decade. Now this happens to be minus 40 dB per decade. The slope of the first line is 0 dB per decade. Here it is minus 20 dB per decade. Afterwards it is minus 40 dB per decade. And we are having a gain for so frequency of 310 radian per second. So likewise, we can easily plot the resultant plot. If you know the magnitude at the origin and the slope contributed by each term and their cutoff frequencies and the resultant slope of the plot. So as per this omega GC, we can find out what is the phase margin, gain margin from the graph. It is 310. We can also find what is the omega GC using the equation. So that's what So this is the second. Now you can see we have the magnitude at the origin is due to only 200, which happens to be 46 dB, and we have the term and their corresponding. Of course, you can see the terms are arranged in the increasing order of the cutoff frequency. This is pi 2500, and the resultant slopes are the individual slopes are 0, minus 20, minus 20, minus 20. The resultant slope happens to be this is 0, and 0 plus minus 20 is minus 20, minus 20 plus of minus 20 is minus 40, minus 40 plus of minus 20 is minus 60. So this is the resultant slope. So once we know, once we have this table, we can easily plot the graph. I can see this is how it is happening. Since this corresponds to a magnitude of 46 dB, now you can see this is 46 dB. So this will be 46 dB till the cutoff frequency 5. And see this happens to be 5 here, so which is somewhere here. So this is corresponds to 5, and you can see the slope is resultant slope is minus 20. We came down by 20 dB, gone to 1 decade. This is a reference point. We did not join till 50 here. We are stopping at 5. You can see now we are stopping at 25, because 25 is the next cutoff frequency. At 25 we can see the resultant slope is minus 40. At 25 we are coming down by 40 dB, going by 1 decade. We have a reference point at 250. We will have a point from here to here, but we extend this line till the next cutoff frequency, which is at 100. So we are stopping at 100 here now. So at 100 the resultant slope is minus 60. So at 100 we are coming down by 60 dB, going 1 decade. We have this point and this point to draw a line of minus 60 dB per decade. Likewise, for any given transfer function, we can write this table. So where it's very important that we need to consider all the terms and their cutoff frequencies in the increasing order, their individual slope and the resultant slope. Of course, as per the calculation, omega PC and omega GCs are 120. This omega GC is 124. But from the graph, it happens to be 130. That's fine. Okay, there will be slight variation in the asymptotic plot and the calculation. We shall see next problem, where we have there is a constant of 10. So there is a pole at the origin, and we have a pole at minus 10, and this is happens to be minus 5. Now we can see we have merged the terms 10 and 1 over s. So because 1 over s doesn't have any cutoff frequency, but it will have a slope of minus 20 dB per decade. The resultant slope initially itself is minus 20. We have the next term having a cutoff frequency 5, which is 1 over 1 plus 0.2s. Its individual slope is minus 20. The resultant is minus 40. And the third term, which is 1 over 1 plus 0.1s, has got a cutoff frequency of 10. Individual slope is minus 20. The overall slope is minus 40. You can see initially it is starting with a slope of minus 20. Now we can clearly observe while writing the magnitude at the origin, we have considered 20 log 10, which corresponds to this, and we also have one more extra term, which is 20 log omega org. So this 20 log omega org is the representation of this pole at the origin. So since we have a pole at the origin, the magnitude will not be just only due to the constant, it's also due to the 1 over s term. So that's why the magnitude at the origin is 40 dB with the value of omega of origin as 0.1 radian per second. Now this is what the resultant plot is. We are starting with the magnitude at the origin with omega as 0.1 radian per second, as this is 40 dB. You can see now this is 40 dB. The initial slope is minus 20 dB per decade. We are coming down by 20 dB. This is 1 decade. So this is that point. This line will be extended till the next cutoff frequency. Next cutoff frequency is there at 5. At 5, the slope changes to minus 40. You're coming down by 40 dB, 1 decade. So if you join this and this point, it is minus 40 dB per decade. But you're stopping here because at 10, there is a change in slope. You're coming down by 40 dB, 60 dB down, again 1 decade. If you join this 10 and 100, the slope is now minus 60 dB per decade. likewise, we can plot this graph.